first break into becoming a professional artist?
I was supposed to finish animation school, and I never did, because I was also working as a student to be able to pay for my schooling. So I already had a job lined up, and at the end of the first year of animation, to work in a hospital to kind of cover the cost for the year after that. And then they fired me at the last minute, economical reasons, can't control that, and find myself with nothing. And struggling to find a job, you know, to be able to kind of pay for the next year. And ended up out of nowhere, I'm not quite sure exactly, you know, you talk about karma and good timing and being there when it matters. Neighbor of mine, my neighbor from my house, knew someone in an animation company I had never heard of and got me introduced to these guys. And by talking to them, really at the time, nothing really happened. There was nothing, you know, like I had already approached a lot of animation companies as student stuff for internship and things. So, you know, you wait and something happens and sometimes it doesn't. And in that industry at the time, there was really nothing really going on. I was not expecting much. But sure enough, 2 weeks later, they call me back and they say, we have someone who just got back from and would like to see your portfolio. And would you care to come back and show it to me? And so I went there, you know, same deal, you show your work and say, this is great stuff. You know, could you do that and hand me a Bible? And I didn't know anything at the time, but the Bible I was handed was Inspector Gadget. And asked me pretty much very simply, says, can you do that? So for me, I didn't even think twice. I said, of course I can do that. Yes. And then I burned midnight oil trying to copy the style to show him something the next day, because I had to come back the next day with some samples and stuff. And that was it. I brought the sample. The guy says, this is great. You're hired. And I had no idea what I was hired for and where I was going. And 2 weeks later, I was in Japan working on Inspector Gadget, having no clue what was going to happen. Oh. And that was the start of my career.
Wow, and in Japan.
And I had never been anywhere else in the world ever. Never left my hometown, and suddenly, you know, flew over there in a completely different culture to do a cartoon, you know, in a TV series that was going to become, you know, one of the biggest things, you know, ever. But I was going to launch the company to become one of the biggest company in the world in 5 years after that. So I was just like, you know, numbing in retrospect, but, you know, for me, I was just following a flow. And, you know, you're 20 years old. The world is your oyster.
No kidding.
It's a job. I'll take it. Japan, why not? And you go there and you know, and that was it, you know. And I was naive enough at the time to think that I was going to work a few months with these guys and go back and finish school. You know how you think when you're students and you're young and stuff. So I'm already thinking, you know, I'm doing my job, you know, and I'm going back to school. And I'm calling the school to tell them I'm coming back. And the director of the school is screaming at me. He says, you dummy, you are not coming back. You know, if you come back, you will not have a seat here in that school. Because he says, what you're doing right now is what the school is struggling to get you to do. And you're already doing it, already way ahead of everybody else. Why do you want to come back to school for? It's like, you're learning already so much more than what the school can teach you. Why are you thinking of coming back?
Wow.